and check whether our widget test is working properly or not. So here our widget testing has failed. And any idea like why it failed? So now let's try to add pump and see whether it does any magic here and make our test case work. And now let's try to rerun our test case and check whether this runs perfectly or not. So here our test case is now passed successfully. And what does this particular line did again? In our previous vlog, we have covered matchers in Flutter widget testing. And now in this part of the vlog, let us now concentrate on a different topic where we were using it earlier, but we have not concentrated much on that particular aspect. So now let's start our vlog on widget testing and try to see the two concepts in this particular vlog based on pump and pump widget. What is a pump and what is a pump widget? In this part of the tutorial, let us cover these two topics, and by the end of this tutorial, you will be having a good knowledge on when to use a pump and when to use pump widget in your widget testing. So now let's get started with this tutorial. Now let's get back to our widget test file here and start writing our first test case. So test widgets, and here let us specify a description like reverse a string. So we are specifying a string and testing that particular string, and thereafter we are reversing and again testing the string. Widget tester, and this is of a type asynchronous here, asynchronous method, so that we wait for the changes and then test them. So the first thing we do is like await tester dot pump widget. So we'll try to pump our my app widget here so that we are able to load our mock screen, and then we are able to identify the widgets present in our screen here. So what are all the widgets we do have here is like a text field, a text widget, and a text button here. All these three things are widgets only. So we do have a text field, a text widget, and a text button. Let's try to identify the text field by using which we are entering a text. So variable text field equal to find by type. So which is of the type text field here. And what we need to expect here, we are expecting a text field finds one widget. So we have seen a detailed explanation on matches, that is finds one widget, finds n widgets, and all these things in our previous tutorial, and I'm providing the link in the description section below. I suggest you to go through that particular tutorial if you are having any queries why we are using finds one widget over here. So now let's test this particular scenario and see the output once. So what we are currently testing is like we are pumping our my app, and then we are identifying the text field over there, and we are checking whether the text field is present or not. So yes, our text field is present and our test is now passed. So now let's go to the step 2 here. Add again await here and tester dot enter text this time. So we are trying to enter some text here into our text field, and what is the text here is like I'm going to enter hello world, so which is what we use mostly. So hello world, and then let's try to expect hello world onto our text field as we have entered this particular text, right? So we are expecting whether this text is properly entered or not. So find text, hello world. And again add finds one widget. And now again, try to run this particular code here so that we get a confirmation that everything is on track. So yes, again, our test is passed now. We have entered a text hello world and we are able to find hello world in our text field. So don't get confused here that we are not seeing anything on the simulator here. So widget testing, we are trying to test the functionality over here. And now let's go to the next part of the testing where we try to identify the button here. So here we have tried to identify the text field, and now let's try to identify the button just like how we did for text field by type. So just for a change, instead of by type, even you can do with by type also, as we have already done for text field, you can just specify button over here, like what are the buttons you have used, like text button or raise button, whatever it might be. So now let's try to find in a different way. So let's try to find by text here. And what is this text again? So come back to our code here, and what we have specified reverse here. Let us find by the text reverse so that there is a button which is specified by the text reverse is present on the screen or not. And what is the next step? You might be already aware of this. Let's expect whether this button is present or not. Expect button finds one widget. So here you may even use finds widgets also, and now try to run this particular test case so that we are able to identify the button on our screen or not. We can just get a confirmation. So yes, again, our test case is now passed here successfully. And for your clarification, let's try to add one more alphabet over here and try to test this particular function now. And let us try to see whether this test case will succeed or not. And here our test is failed. Why? Because we are not able to find any button by the text reverses here. Now you got a confirmation that our test case is working exactly according to the flow. So let's try to remove the additional alphabet and get going with our widget testing. And finally, let's try to tap on this particular button. And how do we do it? Specify await here, tester dot. We have an option to tap the button over here. So like tap and specify on which particular widget you want to tap here. So we do have a button, right? So let's try to tap on the button. When you tap on the button, what was happening? So when you go back to the simulator, when you return hello here, and when you tap on the reverse button, what was happening here? So the reverse of hello was displayed on our screen, right? So the same way, let's try to enter hello world here and try to find what is the reverse of hello world and whether it is being observed when we try to tap on the button or not. Let's try to add expect here, and in the expect, let's try to specify find text. And what is the reverse of hello world? Specify the reverse of hello world, like D L R O W O L L E H. Okay, let's try to specify as they are like capitals, right? So let's do specify like that, and later let's try to make it small letters and test it again. And add finds one widget. Okay, and now let's try to test this and check whether our widget test is working properly or not. So here our widget testing has failed. And any idea like why it failed? So now get back to our first minute of this particular tutorial where I have said like by the end of this tutorial you will be having an idea of what is a pump and what is a pump widget, right? So we have not used pump anywhere over here. So now let's try to add pump and see whether it does any magic here and make our test case work. So let's try to add pump here, and then I will explain what does a pump do over here. So let's specify await pump tester dot pump here. And now let's try to rerun our test case and check whether this runs perfectly or not. So here our test case is now passed successfully. And what does this particular line did again? If you come from the initial stage here, we are trying to pump widget here. We are trying to pump our application onto the screen, and then we started identifying our widgets here one by one, and we have tried to specify some text and try to identify that particular text, and all these things were working fine. But we do have a button here, and when we are trying to tap on a button, we need to again pump our widget here. So when you tap on this particular button, we need to again re-render. We make use of pump here. So what does pump will do is like it will render the screen so that we are able to identify the reverse text here. So that's what it is done. And when you have not identified the reverse text, our test case will fail for definitely, right? So what we are expecting, we cannot see onto the screen. So just like in our simulator, when you have specified hello world here and you have not tapped on a reverse button, and when you tap on a reverse button, what if there is no set state here? Are you able to see the reverse text? So in the same way, we need to re-render the screen with the help of this tester.pump so that our test case will identify the reverse text, and there ends our test case by successfully simulating the reverse text over here. I hope you understood the difference between pump and pump widget. If you are having any queries in this particular implementation, do let me know in the comment section below. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And also, I suggest you to go through our entire unit testing series in Flutter, for which the link I am providing in the description section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.